What I really wish everyone knew about alcohol and drug education school and what it should really look like is the fact that it's a harm minimization approach. So yeah, it's really important that we prevent early uptake of drugs and alcohol, but we also really want to be looking after young people if they start experimenting with drugs and alcohol as well. DEN offers education in schools from grades 5 right through to year 12. It's very much age-appropriate education, so the information we're given to someone in grade 5 is very different from the information we're given to someone in year 11 or 12. It's really important that young people start learning about drugs and alcohol from an early age, because we want to give them the facts, we want to give them information before they actually start to use drugs and alcohol, so again, they can make informed decisions. When we're doing a session for primary school kids, what we're really trying to help them understand is exactly how drugs and alcohol work. So talking about the way it's activating those feel-good chemicals, but the ways that we can actually activate those feel-good chemicals naturally and how important that can be in terms of dealing with stress and other things in life that can come up. When we're doing a session for school staff, what we're covering there is what best practice drug education school actually looks like and some of the ways they can actually implement those practices themselves. So for example, we want to embed drug and alcohol education within the school curriculum and put it in a health and wellbeing context. A parent symposium is a place where parents and guardians can come along and learn about what best practice drug education school looks like, what we're delivering in schools, but also some tips around how they can talk to young people about drugs and alcohol. To organise a parent symposium, the schools can put out a newsletter and get the parents involved in that way. I think it's fair to say that young people are hardwired to be curious and experiment. That might be around the activities they do, it might be around the style of clothing they wear, but it might also be about, they might be curious and want to know about drugs and alcohol. What I love about working with young people in Tasmania and talking about drugs and alcohol is really supporting them to make healthy decisions in their life based on facts, informed decisions.